The Lions blasted the Packers to end the season and now must decide on the futures of coach Jim Caldwell and defensive end Ziggy Ansah. Lions head coach Jim Caldwell and offensive coordinator Jim Cooter on the sidelines, photo, Daniel Mears, Detroit News. Detroit, the atmosphere was surprisingly festive, as if there was still a prize worth taking, or a point worth making. The large crowd cheered as the Lions hit big plays and hammered the depleted Packers, 35-11, in a finale that almost looked like it mattered. But this was as far these Lions would go, and probably as far as Jim Caldwell can take them. To the precipice, but not back to the playoffs. To a modest 9-7 record, not to serious contention. GM Bob Quinn was hired 2 years ago to get the Lions off the treadmill, and since then, they're 18-15, and it's time for something different. Quinn should replace Caldwell, and according to several reports, he likely will. Caldwell's tenure here has been numbingly repetitive, feasting on weak teams, falling to good ones, and the Lions aren't better now than they were in Caldwell's promising first season in 2014, when they were 11-5. Caldwell is not the singular reason the Lions blew the latest prime chance, but eventually, the head coach bears the prime responsibility. More, Justin Rogers Lions grades, Stafford, receivers rise to 4 in season finale. If this was Caldwell's first or second season and the Lions finished with a sweep of Green Bay and a 5-1 record in their division, you might think the program was growing. But after 4 seasons, the Lions must know what they have in Caldwell, a solid coach but not a game changer, and what they must do. Caldwell is expected to meet with Quinn in the next day or so, and if the GM truly has autonomy, I expect he'll make a change. If Quinn and owner Martha Ford are serious about raising standards here, they need to judge Caldwell not against previous Lions coaches. His 36-30 record, 0-2 playoffs, holds up nicely there, but against the Lions' peers. There will be a lot of coaches fired in the NFL, so the Lions should move decisively. Quinn has given no clues about his thinking, although the report that Caldwell's contract extension was merely for a year is a sign of muted commitment. Hunting for clues in Caldwell's demeanor is a fruitless endeavor. Keeping it cool when the game was over, Caldwell walked slowly off the field and gave a quick wave to the fans as he reached the tunnel. The man's strength with his team, calm stoicism sometimes is viewed as a weakness by the public, especially when the Lions start poorly or lack urgency. But he has never complained about perceptions or campaigned to keep his job. More, Lions' Jarrad Davis closes successful rookie year. "Have you ever heard me defend or anything?" Caldwell said. "Not to anybody. I don't make any excuses. That's just not the way I live my life. So we go out, we do what we do, let everybody make an assessment from there. The real assessment is wins and losses, that's the key." Asked what he was most proud of during his 4 seasons, he said, "I'm not done yet, so we'll see." Asked if he expected to meet with the media Monday, he shrugged and said, "I have no idea."